Alright guys, how's it going? Sorry it took so long to get this video out. I did not anticipate the amount of work that was required to kind of get this to where I'm comfortable showing everyone and happy with it. I decided to do a really cool project with my dad. As you all know, my uncle Michael Lynch, he passed away just about 3 years ago now, and he's an incredible musician. And a few years back, or last year, I'm not sure exactly when, but my Auntie Marlene, Michael's wife, gifted me his old Zoom Porta Studio. And in that, it had a bunch of old stuff that he had recorded. Some of it was live, some with the band, some like a single, him doing a single, and then also some stuff that he just recorded directly onto the Zoom. But that Zoom is pretty dated, and the sound quality is also pretty dated, and the quality is kind of... but I figured if I could get stuff off of there then and put it onto my DAW, I'd be able to kind of make it sound a little bit more studio-esque and, you know, make it sound the way it should. So me and my dad got together and decided we'd do a couple of these tunes to start off and kind of just go from there. But it's been a really cool process and project that has definitely helped me deal with Mike's passing and stuff. So as you all know, CCR was one of my uncle's all-time favorite bands, and he did CCR super, super well. And that's always been my favorite covering aspect of my Uncle Michael's is CCR. He does it perfectly. And my favorite song he's ever done, As Long As I Can See the Light by CCR. And so I was able to find that song on his Porta Studio, but it was like a live single version. So it's just the only thing he was able to record, I guess, was his rhythm guitar and his voice. And so what I did was I took that, put it into my DAW, recorded those individually, and then basically constructed the rest of the song using, you know, pianos. And I constructed my own drum set, and I put in my own rhythm guitar and lead solo, because there was no solo. I'm assuming he used the saxophone MIDI solo that he used to use when he would play it live. So I put in my own solo that tried to make it sound kind of like how Mike would play. Definitely nowhere near as good a guitar player as him, but I did try my best. Yeah, so I'm going to show you here kind of what it sounded like initially. So this is what the song, when I first got it off the Zoom, sounded like.
Put a candle in the window. Got a bow adrift the wild.
So pretty bare and, you know, I mean, but it's definitely a good enough quality track to do something with. So yeah. So basically, I took those, downloaded them onto here, or recorded them rather onto here, and then I essentially just added extra stuff of mine. I put in a grand piano, Wurlitzer keyboard, an organ, bass, drums, my own rhythm guitar along with Mike's, and then a solo as well. Yeah, and I think it turned out pretty nice. I spent a while going through a million different mixes for it and basically kind of came up with this. I tried to make it sound kind of somewhat what it would sound like if you were watching Mike do his single, you know, with that kind of thing, using MIDI drums and whatnot, because that's always what he used. And yeah, so basically this is As Long As I Can See the Light after I've completely rehauled it and stuff. And yeah, I really hope you guys enjoy it.
Candle in the window.
right, awesome. I really hope you guys enjoyed that. That was Long As I Can See the Light, CCR, Mike Lynch. This next song is super awesome and super special for a few reasons. The first, I remember I was hanging out with my dad and I got this cool idea. I was like, well, we have this really good version of Soldier of Fortune that Mike did on his Zoom. So I said, well, I already took all the tracks off of the Zoom and uploaded them onto my DAW. Why don't you try singing the lead vocal as well, talking to my dad? And then I told him, I'm like, if you do that, then I can kind of A-B between you and Mike's voice, sharing the lead vocal for this song. And in my head, I really wanted to do this because growing up, I never got to see my uncle or my dad really perform ever because I was too young to go into bars. And ever since I really became a musician and stuff, that's definitely been one of the things that I really, you know, cameras really weren't a thing back then. So there's not really a whole lot of archived anything from them playing together in bands or as a duo together or anything like that. And so I thought, if I could do this, this would probably be the closest I'd get to hearing what that could have sounded like. And so I put this together, and that's basically what I got out of it, was just I get to hear my uncle and my dad play as a basically a duo, or what that would have sounded like. And so we stripped off all the tracks and stuff for this song, and then I added a bunch of my own. I added in a bunch of different keyboards, piano, synths, rhythm guitar. Mike had a really nice kind of, I don't even know how to describe his solo. It's definitely a little different sounding. It's almost kind of country in a Deep Purple song. It's different, but it works really well. But yeah, I just really wanted to have Dad and Mike both in this one. And I decided that I would throw in, instead of using the harmonies that were in it, I decided to record my own harmonies. So I guess it's me, my dad, and Mike in this one, which is really cool. You know, it's definitely something I only got to do a few times. So it's nice to have this for that reason. Yeah, so I'm super excited to show you guys this one. I'll give you kind of a little taste of what it kind of sounded like initially before I did anything to it. This is just kind of how it sounded. So this was like a MIDI organ and a MIDI guitar. And I stripped those out and I put my own in.
I have often told you stories.
So same as the first one. It's good quality, quite a dry recording, which helps because it definitely makes mixing it afterward a lot easier and putting other effects on it.
Waiting
and whatnot,
for the day.
So yeah, this is basically kind of what it sounded like. So yeah, without further ado, this is a really special one. This is Soldier of Fortune by Deep Purple. And yeah, this is Terry Lynch and Mike Lynch, as well as myself. I really hope you guys enjoy.
I have often told you stories about the way I lived the life of a drifter, waiting for the day. Take your hand and sing your songs, then maybe you would say, come lay with me, love me, and I would surely stay. But I feel I'm growing older, and the songs that I have sung echo in the distance like a sound of a windmill going round. Guess I'll always be a soldier of fortune.
something new. Days of old, nights are cold, I wandered without you. Thirty days, thought my eyes seen you standing near. Though blindness is confusing, it shows that you're not near. Now I feel I'm growing older, and the songs that I have sung echo in the distance like a sound of a windmill going round. I guess I'll always be a soldier of fortune. Sound of a windmill going round. I guess I'll always be a soldier of fortune. Yes, I'll always be soldier of fortune.
All right, guys, that was Soldier of Fortune. I really hope you guys enjoyed that as much as me and my dad enjoyed creating that for you guys. It was definitely a great experience to be able to throw all three of us into a project like that. Even though Mike's not here, it's definitely a great way for us all to cope and stuff. And, you know, we definitely miss him and we miss being able to, you know, make music and play music together. So yeah, it's really nice to have you guys tune in and watch this and see what a great musician one my uncle is and my dad still is, you know. And you know, I really appreciate all the support you guys give me too with my music. So yeah, it's just super awesome that you guys are willing to take the time to watch stuff like this. It's definitely a lot of fun for me to create it for you guys. I wanted to throw in one more song for you guys. I was talking to Dad recently, and we thought a cool song to throw in here would be a song called Brothers in Arms by Dire Straits. It's been my dad's favorite band for, I think, ever. And just a really beautiful song, and it's one my dad's always loved but never really did live or anything. I don't think he actually ever played it live for anyone. But it's a beautiful song, and he showed me, and so we recorded a version of it. And yeah, it's just a super awesome song, and I really think you guys will like it. I'm going to put it up with a little bit of a picture montage of my dad and Mike, and yeah, and it'll just kind of show their journey, their musical journey together, as well as their journey of being brothers. And yeah, on behalf of me and my family, we thank you guys for taking an interest in this. And yeah, we just hope you guys are all doing good and continue to stay safe and healthy in this time. But yeah, without further ado, this is Brothers in Arms. I hope you guys enjoy.
These miscovered mountains are home now for me, but my home is the lowlands and always will be. Someday you'll return to your valleys and your farms, and you'll no longer burn to be brothers in arms. Of destruction, baptisms of fire, I've witnessed your suffering, battle raged high, and though they did hurt me so bad, in the fear and alarm, you did not desert me, my brother. So many different worlds, so many different suns, and we have just one world, but we live in different ones.
To make war on our brothers.